dancing might be new to that little one, but once they get the hang of it, it's pretty easy. The Wyoming All-Stars versus South Dakota, this game being played in Gillette, first half. South Dakota wearing the white. This is Bethany Crossweight of Spearfish, draining three of her 8 points from the corner to give the visitors an early 6-0 lead. It took a little bit before the Wyoming girls got on board, and it took teamwork, like this assist from Danny Williams of Gillette to Makora Ford, who is also a Lady Camel. That got rid of the zero, and it's now 6-2. But the opposition was warmed up, and they were burning the nets. Allison Johnson of Beresford is at the top of the key and opening the door for three to help South Dakota jump out to an early 11-2 advantage. That was a big enough hole, and it was time to get out of it. Haley Lagaki of Sheridan strikes for three. The future University of Wyoming Cowgirl led her team with 17, and it's now 11-5. One key to this game was that the opposition had a better transition game. That was Samantha Connect of Aberdeen Central with the block, and then Gabby Hates of Rapid City Stevens will finish on the other end. She's actually a Gillette native and scored 15 points, and her squad leads 13-7. Here was the main scoring threat. Haley Froelich of Lemon, 26 points. Combined, her and her teammates dropped 13 threes, and that's why they led 20-13 at this point. This game was played with two 20-minute halves, and we're still in the first half. We just changed camera angles. Williams takes the long pass and finishes on the other end for two of her 11 points, and Wyoming would eventually take the lead 28-26. They had the numbers in this game. It was 10-6, but when you don't play much defense and give up a lot of threes, then any shorthanded team can get back into this game. Crossweight strikes again to make it 31-29. The home team was doing a pretty good job scoring inside. This is Mally Wright of Sheridan getting the offensive board and putback. It was her only field goal of the game. The Lady Bronx scored 5 points total. Her team is still up 35-31. Wyoming was starting to gel. Here's Katie Kuhn of Laramie. She missed the game in Spearfish because of graduation, but she drove up to play in this game and bury that three to make the score 38-33. The Lady Plainsman was developing a hot hand, and her teammates knew it, so they got her the ball. There's three more of her 16. Now it's a 41-36 contest. But the visitors would not go away. Hafes takes aim and hits the bullseye from the corner. It's down to a two-point contest with the scoreboard reading 41-39. Now there was one more Camel on the home team. That would have been Sierra Toms, and this is her court. She'll stop, pop, and hit for two of her 11. Wyoming is up 47-43. The opposition would tie things up, but there was a few seconds left to untie it. Kuhn collects her own miss and sticks it back in about 1 second ahead of the halftime buzzer. That would provide some much-needed momentum as the girls went into the locker room up 49-47. Second half, you gotta watch this one. It was flat-out robbery, but a smart move by Lagaki, and it was the easiest 2 points of her life. She's gonna do just fine at UW. Home team is up 51-47. The girls were starting to open up a little breathing room in this game. Toms gets the hoop and the hack. She would convert on the three-point play to push the score up to 58-51. They were hitting the long balls as well. Williams eyes it, spies it, and buys it for three. It was good to have one more game in the old gym. It's now 61-54. Actually, that was such a good thought, Ford decided to try it herself. She strikes for three of her nine to help the cause. Now it's 64-58. Let's get someone else in here. Let's try Cassidy Scott of Douglas. She had 12. She also had a teammate of her own, and that was Molly Krajcik, but she did not score. Wyoming is up 69-63. As for the opposition, they kept hanging around. Great save, and then Johnson will bury another three, and suddenly it became a one-point contest with the scoreboard reading 75-74. South Dakota was making a move, and no one was stopping them. Here's Taylor Trokaimonen of Newell dropping three of her 12 points, and the visitors would go back up by a score of 79-75. Wyoming had to regroup, and they did. Shonda Post of Lander with her only contribution of the game, and it was three big ones, and it came at the right time. Things are tied at 83 all. This game came down to free throws and whoever could make the last three. That would have been Kuhn. The only person that we were not able to show was Kaylee Wilson of Rocky Mountain. She scored seven. Every girl did their part, and Wyoming would win this game 91-88 to complete the sweep.